Hello, friends of St. Peter's, and thank you so much for joining us for our 11 o'clock service today. You are in for a treat this morning. This is our Youth Sunday, and our graduating seniors are preaching and offering the anthem. I will warn you in advance, take the time right now to grab a Kleenex, at least one. You will need it. It's very moving service. It always is. At this time, as we're all still staying at home, I found their messages to be even more poignant than usual, and I suspect you will as well. We're blessed this morning to have with us Catherine Brinton, who is one of our lectors, along with Tasha Kuntz. Fran Friesen is here to offer the vestry announcement, but also to play the role of the people, to be your voice through this service. Deacon Bob will be proclaiming the gospel and sending us out with a wonderful and rousing dismissal. And our preachers this morning are Devin Dixon, Zoe Porter, and Gabriel Shearing. Please do note that the bulletin for this service has been posted in the comments, both on YouTube and Facebook, and we want to encourage you to like and share this video so that friends and family members who might be spiritually hungry this morning might find it as well and join us in worship and in this time. Most of all, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Our opening hymn today is O Zion Haste.
Tidings of peace, tidings of Jesus.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Keep, O Lord, the household, your household, the church, in your steadfast faith and love, that through your grace we may proclaim your truth with boldness and minister your justice with compassion for the sake of our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the oaks of Mamre as he sat at the entrance of his tent in the heat of the day. He looked up and saw three men standing near him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent entrance to meet them and bowed down to the ground. He said, "My Lord, if I find favor with you, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought and wash your feet and rest yourselves under the tree. Let me bring a little bread that you may refresh yourselves, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant." So they said, "Do as you have said." And Abraham hastened into the tent to Sarah and said, "Make ready quickly 3 measures of choice flour, knead it and make cakes." Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf tender and good and gave it to the servant who hastened to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, "Where is your wife Sarah?" And he said, "There in the tent." Then one said, "I will surely return to you in due season, and your wife Sarah shall have a son." And Sarah was listening at the tent entrance behind him. Now Abraham and Sarah, who were old, advanced in age, it had ceased to be with Sarah after the manner of women. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, "After I have grown old and my husband is old, shall I have pleasure?" The Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Shall I indeed bear a child now that I am old? Is anything too wonderful for the Lord?' At the set time, I will return to you in due season, and Sarah shall have a son." But Sarah denied, saying, "I did not laugh," for she was afraid. He said, "Oh, yes, you did laugh." The Lord dealt with Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did for Sarah as he had promised. Sarah conceived and bore Abraham a son in his old age, at the time of which God had spoken to him. Abraham gave the name Isaac to his son whom Sarah bore him. And Abraham circumcised his son Isaac when he was 8 days old, as God had commanded him. Abraham was 100 years old when his son Isaac was born to him. Now Sarah said, "God has brought laughter for me. Everyone who hears will laugh with me." And she said, "Who would ever have said to Abraham that Sarah would nurse children? Yet I have borne him a son in his old age." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in reading Psalm 116, verses 1 and 10 through 17. I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication, because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I called upon him.
How shall I repay the Lord for all the good things he has done for me?
I will lift up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people.
Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his servants.
O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant and the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds.
I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people.
In the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem, hallelujah.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions. Go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You received without payment, give without payment. Take no gold or silver or copper in your belts, no bag for your journey, or two tunics, or sandals, or a staff, for laborers deserve their food. Whatever town or village you enter, find out who in it is worthy, and stay there until you leave. As you enter the house, greet it. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it is not worthy, let your peace return to you. If anyone will not welcome you or listen to your words, shake off the dust from your feet as you leave that house or town. Truly, I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town. See, I am sending you not like sheep, out like sheep, into the midst of wolves. So be wise as serpents and innocent as doves. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Those are such powerful words for us to hear as we prepare to hear our graduating seniors offer their sermon this morning. So welcome to Devin Dixon, Zoe Porter, and Gabriel Shearing.
As most of you know, I'm Devin Dixon, and I'm one of the graduating seniors that is part of our wonderful parish. I spent 9 years part of this community, but this year in particular will be one I will never forget. The world seems to be changing so fast lately, and unfortunately, it's the world me and my fellow classmates are leaping into. What a perfect gospel reading we heard today speaking exactly about this. Jesus sending out his disciples into the world to proclaim the good word. As many of you can guess, this means a little more to us seniors at this moment than ever before. We face so much uncertainty each day, currently, with a new issue it seems like every week, that I can only imagine what life would be like as one of the first disciples sent out into an unfamiliar, hostile territory. However, I have faith that the experiences that I have so generously been given by this church will help me to achieve my highest goals. I've had countless memories thanks to St. Peter's Youth, and more importantly to the youth group leaders, including memories like going to Camp Stevens several times and even a life-changing pilgrimage to Greece. I'll miss the amazing sermons spoken by our joyful clergy every Sunday. I've had the opportunity to sing in the choir here for 9 years, half of my life, to fill the church every Sunday morning with music. I've been able to usher when I wasn't singing and be in lector reading at lessons and carols during Christmas. I've been overjoyed to take part in such an important part of the liturgy, an opportunity that I'm lucky to find as a kid. The only thing I'll ever regret is not being able to tell you all of this in person, to not see your smiling faces one last time. There's no place like St. Peter's. I'll never be able to be replaced, no matter where I go, no matter where life takes me. I came to St. Peter's 9 years ago looking for a church, but I didn't find that. I found a home. I'm old enough now to know that that's rare. And I'll always treasure that. Now I go out into the world to spread the love that you have been shown, that's been shown to me by you. Have faith. I'll see you guys sooner than later. I won't be able to stay away too long. Thank you for everything, St. Peter's. Thank you so much.
For as long as I can remember, I've been coming to St. Peter's. When I went into high school, I was honored to be confirmed in the Episcopal Church, because my experiences here taught me that following God was about one thing, love. From day one, my entire family was welcomed to St. Peter's with open arms. I came here week after week, not out of obligation, but because this church is like a family, one that has always embraced me. 2 years ago, I got the chance to go on a religious pilgrimage to Greece with our youth group, and I will never be able to thank the congregation enough for their support. To see ancient sites where the Apostle Paul lived and preached was unforgettable, but our travels also taught me that church doesn't need a building or bulletins. It's about people connecting with each other and with Christ. Every day, no matter how far we had traveled or how tired we were, we took time to pray together and to be with God. Being separated from my friends and family now, at the end of my high school career, is hard. But I'm safe in the knowledge that the St. Peter's community is still here and it is stronger than ever. Most of all, I'm thankful to everyone that has helped me get to this point, even if I can't tell them in person.
Hello. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Gabriel Shearing. I'm graduating from Westview High School, and I have been attending St. Peter's since 2004. This place is like my home. The lessons I have learned and the great memories I have made here are innumerable. When I was writing this, I was beside myself with how to thank all of you who have contributed to my upbringing here in the church. And I decided it's impossible. There are hundreds of you in this congregation who have had impacts upon my life. I thank you all so much. And I am grateful for each and every interaction we have had over the past 16 years. Yet I should keep this short. So there are just a few key points that I want to talk about. Church has helped me to develop three characteristics that I believe will be very useful as I go ahead in life. These are communication, leadership, and spirituality. When I say communication, I mean two different things: talking to people and talking to God. The ability to talk to new people, peers, or adults comfortably is something that develops over time. But I'll tell you what, nothing makes this develop faster as a young kid than walking into a conversation with an adult when you're just trying to sneak over to the donut table past your parents before Sunday school. Talking to God is a different lifelong development. Being introduced to prayer and deep thought and reading of scripture from a young age is important. Having faith that God is there to catch you as you grow up is priceless. And being able to pass God your burdens and stress allows you to keep a clear head and make time for the things you love. I have been through many ups and downs, yet everything has always turned out all right because God takes care of it, and he has often sent many of you to help. The next attribute is leadership. There are so many people at St. Peter's that I look up to as some of my greatest role models. This goes from the priests and all that they do to lead our congregation, to Lee being in charge of our youth. She grew up in St. Peter's and has come back to bring up new high school groups in the youth. I hope that after I am done with college, I can come back here and contribute similarly to this church that I love so much. I have learned other valuable lessons about leadership through the Acolyte program. I've been an Acolyte and now a chalice bearer for 10 years. I wonder if Woody knew that I was only 7 when I started, as I was taller than most 10-year-olds. An Acolyte from such a young age, it's been really neat to look up to the older Acolytes before me, and now try to reiterate that to the younger kids. Finally, is how St. Peter's has helped me to grow spiritually. There is something about the church congregation that emits a different feeling of welcome and community that I have yet to discover in any other group or organization. The overwhelming sense of love that I feel at St. Peter's, the generosity and support that any single person will provide if you need help, the happiness that I feel just being on the campus. It's been really hard being away from home so long this spring, and surely I will miss St. Peter's as I go off to college. But God is with me everywhere, and the experiences I have had at St. Peter's will stay with me forever. I owe who I am to the connection I have made to my church. So hopefully we can be together again soon. Amen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Devin and Zoe and Gabriel, for your witness, for allowing us to be present as you've grown up, and the joy of being able to see you launch into the world. We'll miss you. We look forward to hearing about your great adventures. Again, my heartfelt thanks on behalf of all of St. Peter's.
Let us join together as we recite the Nicene Creed, the foundation of our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, With the Father and the Son, he has worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we prepare for the prayers of the people, a reminder to let us know in the comments, both on YouTube and Facebook, if you're celebrating a birthday this week. We know for sure we're celebrating the birthdays of Glenda and Kirby Baker. Molly Stone had a birthday this week that we've been celebrating. I think Molly gets a birthday month in my vote. We also have, my birthday is also this week. And there may be anniversaries as well. And we want to be able to celebrate them with you. So please do let us know.
Gracious God, give us boldness, justice, and compassion as we offer our prayers, responding, Kyrie eleison. Open our eyes to see the stranger in our midst, offering hospitality and companionship, believing that the Holy Spirit visits us through those we do not know. Let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
Reveal the fruits of suffering to all who are heavy laden with despair, that they may receive your endurance, grow in character, and live in hope. Let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
Strengthen our hands and voices to proclaim the good news of Christ through the daily events of our lives and to those we encounter in the course of the day. Let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
Increase vocations to the various ministries of our church, especially our religious communities, whose members hold the church, her mission, and peoples in prayer, and who work for the joy of the gospel. Let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
Bless our nation, our president, and members of Congress. Give them wisdom in their deliberations, that legislation and programs may serve the best interests of the common good and the needs of the global community. Let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
Hold in your arms of mercy those who are ill, and grant to those who have died a room prepared by your own hands. Let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
O most mighty and merciful God, in this time of great sickness, we flee to you for relief and comfort. Deliver us, we beseech you, from our peril. Give strength and skill to all those who minister to the sick. Prosper the means made use for their cure. Comfort those who mourn or who are in great financial distress. Endue our leaders with wisdom and courage, and grant that, perceiving how frail and uncertain our life is, we may apply our hearts to that heavenly wisdom which leads to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, We confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please do share with one another the signs of God's peace. And indeed, let us bring our hearts together with the birthday and anniversary prayer. Watch over thy servants, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. And in their hearts may thy peace, which passeth understanding, abide all the days of their lives through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. As we come to our offertory, I want to begin simply by saying thank you again for your incredible generosity. You're welcome to make a gift to St. Peter's and our mission and ministry by a text to give at 858-252-0622 or online at stpetersdelmar.net/give. You can also send a check via U.S. mail at P.O. Box 336, Del Mar, California, 92014. Tasha, before I give the offertory sentence, do you want to say anything about this particular offertory anthem?
Yes, I do. So we are very lucky to have today an offering from Claire Karofsky, one of our graduating seniors. She has put so much work into this beautiful piece, and I am so proud of all the work that she's done and so grateful for her courage in lending us her gifts in this way.
Wonderful. Walk in love, as Christ loves us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
Maria.
And now, in the language of our hearts, let us pray as our Savior Christ taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And let us pray together the general thanksgiving. God, our creator, our center, our friend, we thank you for our good life, for those who are dear to us, for our dead, and for all who have helped and influenced us. We thank you for the measure of freedom we have and the extent to which we control our lives. And most of all, we thank you for the faith that is in us, for our awareness of you and our hope in you. Keep us, we pray you, thankful and hopeful and useful until our lives shall end. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless you and keep you on this day and always. Amen. I want to thank Fran for being here to give our vestry announcement this week, but also thank her for 3 wonderful years on the vestry. Fran, it has been a pleasure. Those 3 years have flown, and I can just hardly believe it, and I'm having a hard time imagining vestry without you. So just wait till you hear from a nominating committee near you. Fran, thank you for the announcements today.
I'm along with Dan Malden and Louis Karofsky. Our time is coming to an end. We met last Tuesday night, and some of the important things I'd like to share with you, first being a report from Heather that we will not have to cut the budget. Thank you to your generosity and offerings above your pledges. And we also thank God for this creation. Another item, the vestry approved a generous legacy gift from the estate of Douglas and Marianne Pardee. Mother Page will give you more details about this gift in a future edition of The Spirit and Times. But at this time, if you'd like to make your own legacy gift, please contact our endowment chair, Dan Malden, or email legacy@stpetersdelmar.net. Another important item, our co-convener, Alan, aka Smitty Dorsey, provided us with an update for the Safe Return to Campus Task Force team. The team consists of more than 30 lay leaders and staff on St. Peter's. It has 8 committees representing all aspects of parish life. The task force has met twice. Each committee and committee leaders have also met at least one time. At the July vestry meeting, the task force will present their plan for vestry approval. The task force will also be sending out a survey, and we're asking you to complete this survey to determine how we can best focus our efforts as we contemplate the safe return to our worship in person. And another issue, the vestry enthusiastically listened as Melissa Collins Porter updated us on St. Peter's Sacred Ground pilot group. Information will be forthcoming on this small group experience, which is focusing on the important work of racial reconciliation. Sarah Holmes also reported that the task force is studying other small group opportunities where groups of 10 people may meet for fellowship throughout the year. These small group experiences will be great opportunities to better get to know fellow parishioners and to deepen our faith journey. As I've said, Dan Malden, Louis Karofsky, and I will rotate off. The vestry was very, very complimentary, very honoring for us, for our individual and servant leadership. We are blessed to have served on that vestry, and I'm sure they are going to say goodbye gracefully. And finally, I ask for prayers for the vestry, for our leadership from Paige, Martha, and Bob, and Susan Astorita. But I also ask for prayers for the Safe Return to Campus Task Force. Thank you, and thank you for allowing me to serve you.
Thank you, dear Fran. She modified that announcement ever so slightly to come across as infinitely more humble. Yes, she didn't want to throw all the accolades upon herself that the authors of that report wanted to, but Fran, thank you again. It's been an amazing time. And thank you for basically giving most of my announcements this morning. I do want to thank again our graduating seniors, to Devin and Zoe and Gabriel for their sermon, to Claire for that gorgeous, gorgeous offertory. Yes. If you want a even longer celebration of our wonderful graduating seniors, I want to encourage you to go and watch the video from our 9 o'clock. You'll have a chance to see Jay and Woody and Tasha and Vicky Harney and Martha King say goodbye and thank you to our young people who served in ministry while they were in high school and before. For Gabriel, as you know, did start acolyting when he was 7. And he also, you'll get to see, you know, Woody kind of reacting to that reality that Gabriel alluded to in his sermon this morning. So I encourage you to go back and watch that portion of the service as well, immediately following the piece at 9 o'clock, to really have kind of a baccalaureate experience for these young people in their graduation, and take that time. It'll be worth it, I promise. Thank you so much again for joining us for worship. Our final hymn this morning is Ye Servants of God, and we'll sing it together beginning on page 14 of our bulletins.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.